Now may I present the screen's biggest, littlest dog, little Mitzi Green.
Daddy want me to sing a song all about toys and dolls. But I don't want to. I want to sing a grown-up song. And to be in the right atmosphere, I think I'll put on my evening gown.
Another human so unkind. Didn't you sneak away and leave a note behind? Was that the human thing to do? Know that yours was such a heart of gold, but after I was stolen, all the tales you told. Didn't you let your kisses turn from hot to cold? Was that the human thing to do? Now I'm not trying to patch things up. What's been done must be. Thought I wouldn't even treat a pup the way you treated me, you rascal, you. How could anybody be so darn unfair? You let me hang around until I learned to care. Then you even laugh and leave me crying there. Was that the human thing to do? Was that the human thing to do?
Now, was that the human thing to do? Miss Ginger Rogers has composed a little novelty number entitled Used to Be You. And I'm going to let you in on a little secret. She has dedicated this song to my friend Jack Oakie.
I remember the girl who used to be that kind of a girl, would always be blue. She flirted, she laughed, she danced all divine. No fingers were crossed when she said she was mine. Oh, where has she gone? Who used to be you? I find in her place a stranger to me. The girl in my mind, I love my life through. The girl who used to be you.
Well, goodbye, Louis Delaney. I've got to go back to work.
Well, good luck, Virginia Captain. Goodbye, dear. Oh, say, just a minute. Have you forgotten something?
Oh, yes.
No, my hat.
I hope not too many of you are good at lip reading. We've been asked to show a scene typical of nightlife in Hollywood. For this purpose, we have enlisted the services of the famous Brox sisters and Jack Duffy.
Love's always been my guest. Say it how I may, I was made that way. God has been blessed to me that and these there wings there. I know I'm not to blame for
well, you really can't blame Jack for falling. I could fall for them myself. And next to star of radio, stage, and screen, the world's greatest banjoist, Mr. Eddie Peabody.
Hello there, people!
Hello, Eddie!
You ready for the show?
Yes, dear speaker, but there's nothing in the mouth.
Well, hurry up and ask it, because I'm raring to go.
The question is, dear speaker, what makes the mouth go?
So that's the foolish question. You embarrass me. Me. Girls, I'd like a chord in G, please. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's the chord in G, folks, regardless of what you think.
Gentlemen, how do you do? May I introduce myself? I am Eddie Kane, manager, producer, and master of ceremonies of this all-star show. In other words, what there is around here, I am. Several of our stars have not appeared as yet. However, the studio assures us that they will appear before the night is over. Trusting you enjoy the show, I thank you very, very much.
Oh, say, Eddie, could I... talk to you for about a minute.
A minute?
Yeah, just 1 minute.
I haven't got time now. Wheeler and Woolsey?
Ah, hello, Eddie, my lad. Hello. What's on your mind, son? What's
don't
on
you
mind?
Know you go on in 2 minutes?
Oh, well, you see, Eddie, we're a little bit stuck. Now, if you'll help us out, I mean, we'll be on there in 2 minutes.
What do you mean?
Well, now, we got to have somebody to kind of work up the gag for us. Now, the first thing you do, Eddie, will you do it for us?
Well, if I have to,
okay,
yes.
Okay, now, here's what you have to do. Now, look, Eddie, it's very simple. You stand here like this, see? Look, standing here with the foot out like that.
Yeah, get it out a little further.
Yeah, a little more, Eddie.
That's it.
Attaboy. Now, look, Eddie, put the hand on the hip like this. Attaboy. Now, turn the head like this.
Are you all set now?
Yes.
Well, stay that way, you big sissy.
Are you ready, Poo-Poo-Padoo?
How's the house?
It's packed.
Oh, well.
What are you going to sing tonight?
Well, of course, Poo-Poo-Padoo.
That's what I thought.
3 minutes, Jackie.
Okay. Yeah?
Are you ready?
Well, I thought it was only 3 minutes.
Come on, you've only got a second.
Yay. Come in.
Miss Wong, will you please go on next for me?
Why, the first act has just gone on.
I know, but something just happened. Helen Kane just sprained her ankle, and I pulled Jackie Cooper's arm so hard, I've dislocated his shoulder, and you've got to go on next.
But I haven't my public face on yet.
Look, I'll go up and tell him to do an encore, and there'll be plenty of time. But have you decided what you're going to do?
Well, let's see now. I think I'll do the Chinese poem.
A Chinese poem?
Yes. You know, the one that goes like this. Hon yi de lan gong, ye yi ba Pan man, Lung hak cho san ku, Lok yong, Tin yu ngui liang mun, Yit pina ban lin, Doi yo ka wu. Did you like that?
Oh, that was lovely, but there was one word in there I didn't like.
Which one was that?
Never mind. They won't know the difference anyway. You know, it's awfully nice of you to do this for me.
Well, I'm only too happy to help out.
Now, I'll go up and tell them to do an encore, and everything will be fine.
Righto.
Eddie, I just gotta talk to you. You gotta listen. Tanner, will you listen to me?
Well, go ahead.
Well, you see, Eddie, see, I was a...
Save it. Good evening, Miss Doug.
Good evening.
Doug, can I talk to you just a minute, please?
Can't you see I'm busy?
Oh, I'm sorry.
I won't be long, Douglas. Will you wait here for me?
Right on the spot.
All right. Thank you.
Who's dressing in here?
Don't know.
Can I see you just a minute, please?
Why not?
A pansy!
How mortifying. How mortifying. Even though I was a pansy with this face, they wouldn't believe it.
I'm sorry.
Pardon me, will you please? I just saw your act in the wings.
Well, I think you're swell. You know, you're my favorite.
That's very kind of you.
Would you autograph my program?
I'd be very happy to.
And you too, please.
Oh, certainly.
You know, I've always liked you in pictures, Mr. Fairbanks. And you too, Miss Talmage.
Tom, you're a great pistol shot. You hit everything out there but Jimmy Durant's schnozzle.
Don't see how I missed that.
Neither do I. Are you leaving?
Well, I'm thinking about going out.
Are you all alone?
Oh, no, I got my friend with me. Come on, fellas.
To get into the movies, but you have to pull a lot more to work a puppet.
Oh, Dorothy, there he is.
Oh, won't you please listen to him?
All right, go ahead.
Well,
what is it?
I forgot.
Didn't I tell you?
Oh.
Well, maybe I'm wrong.
Lesen Sie in Hollywood, am Parade, von die weltberühmte Künstlerin Marlene Dietrich.
Y la favorita artista de todos los países de habla española, Lupe Velez.
Jung Guaka Ming Sing, Anna May Wong,
of Greta Garbo.
5% till film waren.
Lise de l'Etoile de France, Maurice Chevalier.
And his American prima donna, Jeanette MacDonald, who appears in this issue of
Hollywood on Parade. Every fan magazine has a portrait of a star on the cover. On the next page is the index. In this particular instance, I am the index.
Who are you?
I am
Bride.
Dracula.
Fu Manchu.
Frankenstein.
Sean Doe.
Oh, Mickey Daniel!
Mickey Daniel!
I'm just a loose leaf from the comic section.
Hey, Mickey, what's going to happen to the ending?
But I have what I consider a very unusual collection. And here it is. Sanguines. Funny little bird found all the way from the South Pole to the equator. There are none at the North Pole. I've collected these both in America and in Europe, and so many of them have been sent to me by fans. Their chief value to mankind, as far as I can determine, is to appear in pictures made by explorers to the South Pole. This one was the star of a Zane Grey production. He died as the result of too many camera shots.
Here in Hollywood, an artist sculptured a stampede to beautify an unsightly city lot under the sponsorship of Ken Maynard.
Well, Mr. Anderson, your work's shaping up here pretty good, isn't it? You got a lot of longhorns there, all right. Tongue sticking out of that critter there looks mighty lifelike. Got a lot of nice stock there.
Oh, boy, who?
Well, I'll tell you, I guess I better get on old Tarzan and go home. You want to hold him down for me? I guess I can make it, though, now. Oh, boy, hold Tarzan. Hold. Easy, boy. Easy. Look out now. I'm coming out of here snorting. Come on, Tarzan, let's go to the crowd. Come on.
My heart seems to repeat what I felt at the start. Each little sign tells me that I adore you, Louise. Just to see and hear you is joy I never knew. But to be so near you thrills me through and through. Anyone can see why I wanted your kiss. It had to be, but the wonder is this. Can it be true? Someone like you could love me, Louise. Every little breeze seems to whisper, Louise. Birds in the trees seem to twitter, Louise. Each little rose tells me it knows I love you. I love you. Every little beat that I feel in my heart seems to repeat what I felt at the start. Each little sigh tells me that I adore you, Louise. Just to see and hear you is joy I never knew. But to be so near you thrills me through and through. Anyone can see why I wanted your kiss. It has to be, but the wonder is this. Can it be true? Someone like you could love me, Louise.
Listen to your favorite tale. Sing a song or dance for you in this televised review. Meet your movie king or queen enthroned upon the silver screen. Now watch that escapade in Hollywood on parade, for Hollywood is on parade.
But after all, it is great to be great enough to be made into a wax figure for the Hollywood Hall of Fame in this motion picture museum. But just to break the monotony and stuff, and this being my day off, how's about you and me stepping out? Let's visit some of our old motion picture star friends. Hmm? Well, if that's the way you feel about it, that's the way you feel about it.
Well, my old friends Conrad Nagel and Dolores Costello, stepping out just as they did in Glorious Betty. Well, step over and see me sometime. Ah, the It girl, Clara Bow. Now, there's a girl really worth stepping out with. Yes, sir, I could go for her in a big way. I certainly could go for her in... But there's the obstacle. Her husband, Rex Bell, always by her side. Well, life is life, just the same. Now, Clara, there's one thing I've always wanted to ask you. You got a light? Thank you.
Say, Eddie, there's something I wanted to ask you, too. I thought you were a pal of mine.
Well, Rex, I thought so, too.
Well, why don't you find some other girl instead of my wife?
Well, who would you suggest?
Well, how about Betty Boop?
The new little girl that Max Fleischer made. Well, if he can make her, I can go over and say hello.
Say, Eddie.
Yeah?
Be careful that you don't melt the wax.
Yes, sir. And you know, ever since I saw you in the screen cartoon, I've often wondered... See your garter. See it was real diamonds.
Rex, you go away, you big bad man. Ooh.
Now you know you don't mean that.
You know, Betty, honey, you know, I like to hear you sing a song.
Can we sing? Mm-hmm. Okay, I'll sing if you play piano for me.
You will?
Uh-huh.
All right, you boop and I'll play.
Okay. Can you play My Silent Love?
If you call me that, huh, darling, I'll play it anything.
Okay.
Betty Boop?
Oh, no catching Betty Bloop.
Hey.
Hmm? No catching Betty Bloop.
No, Boop.
Bloop.
Boop.
Bloop.
Look, once and for all, it's Betty Bloop. You got me talking like that. Now, look, she was kidnapped, and I'm I don't think you... Do you know Betty Boop?
Oh, you bet I got to
Oh, yeah? Well, she never told me anything about it. But anyhow, I'll be seeing you and... Hey, Warner, did you say anything of my girl, Betty Boop? She's been... I say, did you see anything of... Did you see it... What's that? Wax in your ear or something. But I'll try this one. I say, my girl has been kidnapped, understand?
Gonna eat so.
Oh, hello, Dorothy.
Hello. You look for somebody, no?
I'm looking for somebody, yes. Hmm. I'm looking for my girl, Betty Boop.
Why you look for this Betty Boop?
Hey, not Boop. Boop.
Boop.
Well, that's near enough. Well, the reason I'm looking for her is because she's my girl and I love her. Okay. That's why I'm looking for her.
See?
And when you love a girl, you love her. Well, I used to love her. I think.
You got something for me, ma?
Excuse me, just a minute. Don't go away. Hi, Vic. Hello, Ed.
Say, did you see Betty Boop?
I say, you boys know what I'm looking for?
Well, I wasn't, but it's a good idea. Thanks, brother. Yes, sir. Brother, this is, without a doubt, the most invigorating, the most delicious glass of panther blood I've ever tasted.
See you later. Oh, Murray and Sydney. Hey, will you fellas help me find Betty Boop? I say, did you fellas see anything of Betty Boop? Oh, well, what can you expect from a couple of dummies like
that? What do you mean, dummy?
Who is a dummy?
Oh, hello, George. How
hello,
are you?
Hello.
Well, George.
Hello.
Hey, wait a minute. I'm in here, too, you know.
And Charlie, say, Betty Boop has been kidnapped. Will you help me find her?
Who?
Betty Boop.
What's her name?
Who?
Oh, Boop. Boop. Hey, Boop.
Hey, don't you boop me.
Well, Boop.
Oh, look, a nest of them. She ought to be in this bunch.
No.
Cold as Chelsea's eyebrows. Oh, there's old man Mecca. Mr. Teamer.
Maybe over here, right? No.
Warm. Warm, hot. Getting hot, sizzling. Oh, Charlie, sizzling.
Hello, big boy.
Look, I found her, look. Hey, Eddie. Eddie, we found her.
No, she won't do. She's the wrong one.
What did he say? Said she won't do. Do what? Come on, let's take her home. She's at least alive.
Sure.
Hey. Get a hold there. Come on.
Teddy!
Teddy!
Stop! What's that remark?
Stop, I say.
Well, who are you to stop me in the middle of the afternoon, or evening, or now?
I am Chandu, the magician.
You can't fool me, Dane Whitman.
You must return to wax. Wax thou art, and to wax thou shalt return. Chandu has spoken.
Why did you do that to my Eddie? What's the matter with you?
And gentlemen, the music you've heard played is Hollywood on Parade, our theme song. Toothpaste and motor cars and things we eat and wear are sung around on the air in theme song. Most movies that you see play up some melody. Where would I, Cliff Edwards, be without my theme song? And now we're going to treat you to the theme song of our feature. It's a number any jungle film might use. It's a hauntin' tauntin' songo of the far mysterious Congo, and it's sung by its composer, Clarence Muse.
Night and day, I find no peace. Sad okay, it does not cease. Strange wild beat, so deep and low. Mad black feet must be the Congo. It's a sad river with a wild soul and a long dawn.
Beautifully.
Really, you like it?
Very much, yes.
You think you like it as well as you do when it's sleepy time down south? No?
I think I do, yes.
Well, that's good. You know, I think I went Congo when I was trying to write that tune.
We simply must have our theme song, and when the newsreel is shown, don't give it the razz if you find that it has a theme song all its own.
These are movie stars at play. Listen in on what they say. Through the screen I bring them all at your command. Everything your favorites do, I'll report at once to you. I'm the eyes and the ears and the voice of movie land.
Yes, indeed, ladies, but the little white pill is a golf ball. Look at that drive, all of 200 yards. The platinum-haired screen siren swings a mean golf club and a mean hip, if you get what I mean. And now she's going to putt. What's the ball? I said, what's the ball? You must agree that Miss Harlow shows good form.
Buenos dias, amigos. Greetings from sunny Mexico, the land of hot foods and cold drinks, where the favorite sports are horse racing and bullfighting. The horse racing is for the Americanos. We Mexicanos prefer the good old sport of throwing the bull. Here is Alice White and Sai Bartlett waiting for the first race. What? No beer? No, it is only ice water. They are watching something on the track. No, it isn't a big electric toaster. It is an American invention to control the way the horses start. What we really need is something to control the way they finish. There are the charming Bennett sisters, Constance and John, who are among our visitors today. That's Constance doing a good turn for someone. Carol Lumber has a tip on the winner, so she's telling her husband, William Power, in a hoarse whisper. But Bill likes to pick them himself. He's looking them over carefully. Take your time, Bill. There is prosperity. Everybody's betting on her. Richie Finn is second choice. Locomotive and Warner's are sure to show. Senores Wheeler and Woolsey pick them the same way. They are good judges of horse plays. They used to eat in French boarding houses. Here is Claudia Dell, away up in this grandstand. She wants to be sure that no fat man will jump up in front. Yours when the race gets excited. Look who's with the judges. Our own Mexican star, Raquel Torres. Now, Raquel, how do you expect the judges to keep their minds on the track? Now watch closely. One, two, three, they're off. Everybody's excited. Harry Langdon has $5 on Warner. Polly Moran just paid a last-minute punch of prosperity, the horse that was named after one of her pictures. Here they come, into the home stretch. Locomotive has the rail. Warner's is out in the front. Boston is right behind her. But where is prosperity? Too bad, Polly. Prosperity is still around the corner. Adios, amigos.
Now you've heard the different theme songs that they use. For the prologue, feature picture, short and news. But the kind of a theme song now that wins acclaim is a ditty built around a movie name. All the boys of Tin Pan Alley write of Chloe, Min and Sally, Marianne and Jane and Betty and Noreen. But the cream songs of the dream songs are the star-inspired theme songs that they sing to lovely ladies of the screen. Plunk, plink.
Lupe, eres todo mi amor, Lupe, tuyo es mi corazón, eres dulce sueño de amor, astro que disipa dolor. Lupe, cuánto te quiero yo, Lupe, por ti me muero yo. Lupe, Lupe divina, quiéreme mucho, cual te amo yo a ti. Lupe, I'm a more than you play. Lupe, if I die you to blame, you may follow the things I say. You take all my hopes away. Lupe, lost a game for a fair. You play in a way that's unfair. Chiquita, sweet señorita, please make life sweeter and say that you care.
Enchilada or La Jolla CC chili con carne of hmm. Hmm?
Why don't you explain to us in English?
In English? Yeah. Well, let's play Hollywood on Parade, you know, the theme song. All right?
See?
All right.
On the silver screen. Now watch that escapade in Hollywood on parade, for Hollywood is on parade.
How do you do?
Mr. Briani, I'm the model Mr. DeMille recommends to pose for you as Miss Hollywood.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Not bad. Not bad at all.
What did you say, Mr. Bagani?
Oh, I never said anything at all. I was only thinking.
Shall I remove the suit?
That's a great idea. No, no, that's not necessary.
I thought you said to.
Oh, some of the pictures must be coming to life. I say, Kivisa, did you say anything? A little friend of mine was suffering terribly with rheumatism. So we went to the doctor, and the doctor said the best thing for you to do is go to Atlantic City and take a bath in the ocean. Salt water is marvelous for rheumatics.
So he got there. It was 7 o'clock in the morning. It was cold, so he didn't want to go in. So he bought himself a pail and went down to the ocean and scooped up a pail of water to take back to the hotel to take a bath. A policeman sees him doing this, thought he'd have some fun. He says, what are you doing? She's nothing at all. My feet hurt me. I got too much disease in the feet. The doctor told me the best thing is a little salt water from the ocean. I'll take back to the hotel a pail and take a bath there. The policeman says, that pail of water will cost you 50 cents. He says, that's all right. So he paid the 50 cents, went back to his hotel and took his bath. 4 o'clock in the afternoon, he's got to take another bath. He comes down to the ocean, he takes a look and he says, he sees it's low tide and he says, what a business they've done here today.
Now let us see if we can find some unusual pose for Miss Hollywood.
Why not let a pose like Bebe with a lot of loving cuts? Yes,
congratulations, my girl. This is in behalf of Miss Lyon. Beautiful day. Here's one for you.
Thank you. I'm running out of cups.
Thank you. How would you like to sit on the top of the world?
That would be an unusual pose.
Well, just a minute. Hollywood, just the right spot for you.
You'll soon be sitting pretty.
For once, you are sitting on the top of the world. Look this way. Now turn around.
Was that all right?
Fine. Let's make one standing now.
All right.
All right, boys.
Take that away, will you, Charlie?
Thank you.
Miss Pickford, the committee is here from Pasadena.
Oh, you mean the Pasadena Tournament of Roses Committee?
Yes.
Oh, we'll ask them to come in, will you?
All right. May I introduce Miss Dorothy Edwards, Queen of the Pasadena Tournament of Roses.
I'm delighted
and her
to meet you.
Attendant.
How do you do? Miss Pickford, we hereby appoint you Grand Marshal of the 44th Annual Tournament of Roses Parade to be held in Pasadena, California. Well, I'm highly honored, and I'll be delighted to be with you. Thank you. And we present you with these Pasadena roses. Oh, they're lovely. Thank you so much.
I'll see you in the parade, Mary.
I see you have talking pictures.
You were silent when I got them.
I see you have a picture of John Bowles with Buster Collier in the row.
Yes, I shot it last summer at Malibu.
They were short of men. How about playing first for us?
Gee, boy, I'd love to play, but I've just got through 6 sets of tennis. Wait, there's old Bob Woolsey. He'll play with you. Hey, Bob!
Hiya there, Buster.
Hiya, Bob.
Hiya, hello, kid. John. Haven't seen you since Rio Rita.
How's the old kink at you?
Okay, kid.
Bus wants a first baseman. I told him you were swell.
What a manager. Who are you playing, Buster?
Buster Keaton's team. How about playing first with Bob?
Oh, I'm sorry, but I'm not dressed for the occasion, Buster.
Oh, sure you are. Those clothes are good enough.
No, not for me. When I play golf, I play in golf clothes. When I play polo, I play in polo clothes. Because I don't like to brag or go, you know, brag about my dressing or things like that. But sometimes, Buster, I change my clothes 4 or 5 times a day, if the occasion demands.
That's nothing. I got a brother that changes his clothes 4 or 5 times an hour, if the occasion demands.
Got a brother that changes his clothes 4 or 5 times an hour?
If the occasion demands.
How old is he?
6 months.
I want to make this picture fine enough to place it in that large frame where you see Johnny McBrown.
Well, Mr. Pogani, if that's the way you feel about it, I'll step down and you can have this frame right now.
Johnny, just a minute, Johnny. I was only kidding. If you'll be a good boy and go back into your frame, I'm going to introduce you to a beautiful model.
That'll make me very happy.
Well, Miss Batchelor is posing as Miss Hollywood. How do you like her pose?
Great. But you know, I've been thinking that you need more than one model to represent the spirit of Hollywood.
Well, what did you suggest?
Why, take Miss Batchelor's form and the composite features of the Wampus Baby Stars of 1933, and you'll have it.
Who are the Wampus Baby Stars?
Why, they are the girls the Hollywood studio publicity men have selected as most eligible for screen stardom the coming year.
It's a great idea, but where are these girls?
Ah, come with me.
Well, how do you like it?
fine. Here they are, Mr. Pogami. The best bets of cinema land. 14 lucky girls. One from each studio. Hollywood's unanimous choice as the stars of tomorrow. We would like to see your profile, Ruth Hall.
Is this what you want?
Exactly.
Patricia Ellis, will you kindly turn?
Want me to turn completely round?
You're very obliging. Thank you, Miss Ellis. Now, Lillian Bond, please remove your cape.
My cape? Oh, you want me to take it off? Some other time.
And now, a Ziegfeld girl, direct from the Follies, Miss Boots Mallory.
Is my hair all right?
We'll say it is.
Now hold that pose, Miss Knapp. Raise your chin slightly.
I'm very anxious to see what this is going to look like.
And so are we.
Dorothy Layton is next.
Do you want me to drop my chin?
Go right ahead. I'll pick it up.
I can't help but smile.
Now be serious, Dorothy Wilson.
Now you be serious, Johnny.
How long do I have to hold this position?
Oh, about 25 hours out of 24. Mary Carlisle. Marion Shockley, also apparently impatient.
Well, I'm certainly glad I'm not an artist model.
Presenting Toshi Mori, a bit of Dresden, China.
No, I'm not Chinese. I'm Japanese.
Oh, excuse, please. Now, where do you hail from, Gloria Stewart?
I'm just an all-American girl.
Eleanor Holmes.
Gee, these studio lights are hot. When can I go for a swim?
The Olympic champion wants to go for a swim.
And I suppose Ginger Rogers wants to dance.
I'd much rather dance than do this.
We knew it!
Have you heard how Lona Andra happened to come to Hollywood?
I got in pictures by being a Panther woman.
So how do you like it, Johnny?
Well, I think it's good enough to go in my frame.